I appreciate Mayor Dave Free joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Hey, Dave, how are you?
Good morning, Bill. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Dave, I got to ask you, you tell me, you know, this seems like a big victory for you from a political standpoint, certainly. I got to believe your constituents are happy because not only do you keep the jobs, but you got Amazon, this, you know, Goliath major international company to say, okay, we'll stagger the traffic. So first tell me how that happened and how did you win this thing? And then I got a question for you.
Well, I think, you know, really everybody won. You know, the residents won, the employees of Amazon won, and Amazon themselves won. This is a good day for everyone involved. And frankly, it was a public safety issue that had to be fixed. So I was really glad that we were able to come to the table.
All right. So the obvious question, Dave, is we are not unfamiliar in this state with traffic studies, right?
Sure.
And there are plenty of people in the government that can tell you how to do one. How was one not done before this? Because when all the politicians, yourself included, you know, taking credit for creating all these jobs and saying, hey, this is a great thing, and I don't disagree with you. But the time to have this conversation, I would have thought, would have been when Amazon was hiring the people.
Sure. And that makes a lot of sense, Bill. And in fact, you know, we saw last year that they had an uptick during the holiday season, and it was before the site was fully operational. So in September of this year, we sat down with Amazon. Yeah. And we tried to work out a plan with them, and we let them know that the only way it was going to work via the traffic studies were if they were going to stagger the shifts. Unfortunately, they've been resisting since that meeting in September.
So why? I mean, you know, are they saying that it will adversely impact their business? I mean, is it completely unrealistic for a company like that? I would think that they would need constant employee flow into their building 24 hours. You know, the internet's all day.
Sure, and it logistically is a tough thing to do, and you know required some work on their part, and also required some change in the way that they normally do things, and change is scary for everyone. So, Dave,
let me ask you: Do you take any responsibility, and do you think that maybe there's a bad message here? I mean, I've spent a lot of time talking to Lieutenant Governor Kim Guadagno and others about how do you create a business friendly climate in New Jersey. We already have the highest taxes in the nation. We already have this onerous burden that's put on small businesses. You know, according to United Van Lines, you got more people moving out than moving in. You know the whole story.
Sure.
How much responsibility do you take saying that when you attack a company? After they're already here, does that send a message to other companies to say, man, Jersey is not the place I want to do business?
I don't think so at all. I mean, in that park, we have Mercedes-Benz, we have McKesson Corporation, we have McMaster Car, we have major Fortune 500 companies. All of them submitted traffic studies, and all of them follow the rules. Amazon submitted their own traffic study, and they built infrastructure based on the traffic study that they submitted. You know, my job is to make sure that everyone, all the companies, follow the rules equally. And when Amazon wasn't following the rules, they were creating a situation that was also impacting the other companies in that park.
So what rules did they break?
They basically agreed to 1,000 trips in the morning and 2,000 trips in the afternoon at peak period. Now, the only way that they could stay within those numbers was to stagger their shifts. So when we saw them hiring more people, we told them, you have to stagger your shifts or we have to create more infrastructure, but you have an approval based on so many trips. And it was their testimony, not ours. It was their trip studies. It was their traffic study. You know, they told us what they were going to create, and we built an infrastructure around what they said they were going to do. When they changed those numbers, when they hired more people than they were supposed to, they either had to, A, stagger the shifts, or B, we had to create more infrastructure.
Now, when you say that, though, it sounds like a negative. I mean, did you, you know, my question is, like, how did it not occur to anyone that it was going to go from 2,000 to close to 5,000 or 4,000 trips in that afternoon, knowing that any retail company like this is going to have a seasonal increase?
And they had planned for the seasonal increase. You know? So, you know, we knew as it was happening in September that this was going to become a problem this year, which is why we started meeting with them months ago.
So, Dave, did you sigh a huge, like, sigh of relief when they agreed? Because you probably didn't want to be the mayor that sued the one company that decided to come to New Jersey and actually create jobs?
Oh, you're 100% right. I mean, look, the last thing we wanted to do was shut down Amazon. But on the other side of the coin, it was creating a serious public safety hazard. And if I had to bring a ambulance into that site, we wouldn't be able to do it. I had 5 police officers working 3 hours a day, two times a day, 7 days a week, just to be able to keep the traffic flow from backing up all the way to the New Jersey Turnpike.
Were these true stories, though? People could not get out of the driveways? I mean, I read that.
100% true. I mean, literally, people couldn't get out of the driveways. And some of the other businesses in the park couldn't get their employees out of their driveways. You know, accident count was up. You know, normally an accident count in that area has about one accident every 6 weeks. We had 25 accidents just in the last 2 weeks. So someone was going to get seriously hurt, and the traffic was so bad. If someone got seriously hurt, I was concerned I couldn't get an ambulance to them.
Yeah. All right. Well, I have to give Amazon a lot of credit for coming to the table. This happened without courts. This happened in a backroom negotiation, right? Handshakes, and you moved on.
Yeah, listen, it was a tough 24 hours, but at the end of the day, you know, when you get 25 people with opposing views all into a room and everyone walks out happy, it's a good day.
All right, there you go. Mayor Dave Freed, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Congratulations. You actually got this to, you got these two sides to meet in the center, and it sounds like it's a win-win, and maybe we can move on and continue creating jobs. But I would say that we need a lot more work on the infrastructure before the next thing happens.
I completely agree with you, Bill, and I was glad to see that we could bring everybody to the table, and that's ultimately what our job is. Bring everyone to the table, come up with a good solution.
All right, Dave, there you go. Congratulations. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
All right, take care.